गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, टुडे माय मीटिंग फॉर क्लास 7 सब्जेक्ट साइंस चैप्टर नंबर 7 वेदर क्लाइमेट एंड एडेप्शन। टुडे आई विल एक्सप्लेन रिमेन पार्ट ऑफ दिस चैप्टर।
रिमेन पार्ट
ऑफ दिस चैप्टर। Today I will start adaptation in animals.
Adaptation
in animals. Adaptation in animals. Animals. Okay, my dear student. Adaptation is acceptedness of the weather. How to accept the weather? It depends on your ability. Climate affords. Climate differ from place to place, as ether temperature differ, monsoon temperature differ from ether temperature. Calcutta temperature also differ from the ether temperature. Gujarat temperature differ from the ether temperature. J&K temperature differ from the ether temperature. So it depends on the temperature. It's a fact that life form in a region, life forms in a region, animals have special features that enable them to live comfortably. In their habitat. Habitat means a place where they live. Habitat means a place where they live. These special characteristics that enable plant and animals to live comfortably in their habitat are known as adaptation. Means animals live which place and what is the condition according to him. What they want, if the climate change, what will they do, what will they go from changing of the climate, this is the adaptation. Adaptations of animal living in extremely cold place of the earth. Now we'll start adaptation of animals.
Adaptation. Animals living in cold places, of the earth.
Come on, student. The Arctic region located at the North Pole and Antarctica region located at the South Pole are known for their extremely cold climate. Because the polar region always cold. They are covered with snow throughout the year. Fully year covered by the snow. Few kinds of animals and birds that are adapted to live in such harsh conditions are found here. Polar bear, Arctic fox, Arctic hare, hares like a rabbit, reindeer, deer just like resemble as a, we can say polar deer. Reindeer is like a polar deer. Are found in the Arctic region. All these animals have adaptation to keep their body warm. How they live, their place, how they walk, how they eat. So it depends the animals. It depends their conditions. But they all live. They all are adapted. They all adapt all condition. By this region, adaptation By this reason, adaptation of the animals for the polar bears are different from the here animal. The polar bear is generally adapted to live in the ice cold climate, the Arctic region. Some of its adaptation are discussed in your book. A polar bear has a thick layer of fat called blubber under its skin. Its body is covered with two layers of dense, fine fur that trap air and insulate it and the animal from the cold. Therefore, polar bear moves slowly and takes rest of it to avoid getting overheated. So this figure, my student, you can see polar bear. The figure 7.8, polar bear. The page number 99. The transparent for reflect light, the transparent fur reflect light and appears white. This conflicts against the snow enable to polar bear to blend into the white surrounding and sneak up to its prey. Attack on the prey by hiding some things. The polar bear is an active swimmer. With wide and large paw, wide and large paw help in swimming. While swimming underwater, it can close its nostrils. This allows the animal to remain underwater for a long period. So this type of the body's characteristic help to their animal in their place. Is up north poles. The pads of the paw have many small, soft papillae, which help polar bear in gripping the ice while walking. When they walk, then grip the ice. By the help of paws, they can grip the ice. The polar bear has a very strong sense of smell, which helps to locate and catch its prey. During winter, polar bear remain inactive or dormant. Is called the hibernation, just like sleep, just like sit at this, they are no, when they sit and look like this, they are not doing some work, not feel good. By this reason, dormant means lazy. The time this body shows like a lazy, this is called the hibernate. Some of the adaptations seen in other animal. I wrote a book. The Arctic fox and Arctic hare are larger in size and their counterpart found in warmer climate. They have short furry ears and tails to prevent heat loss. Their thick long coat keeps them warm. Their large furry paws help them to move in the snow. Easily, the diet of the reindeer mainly consists of moss. Moss just like the black portion of the any other place on the water, sometime on the wall, you can see moss. Moss not a big plant, just like moss. So reindeer eat the moss, which contains chemical that prevent the animal for freezing. The Arctic region is home to emperor penguins, large flightless birds, known for their stately demeanor, daily demeanor, stately, look like the good, and they have a style doing work. They live on the ice and its surrounding ice cold waters of Antarctica. To survive in such hard climates, the emperor penguins are equipped with several adaptations. Penguins are excellent swimmers. They have streamlined body and bare feet that for the help in swimming. Their short overlapping feathers are densely packed, protect them from ice wind and providing a waterproof coat. The dark colored feather on the back absorbs sunlight, providing warmth. Dark colored back provide the white color, reflect the light, and dark color absorb the light. So by this is a penguin's backside, it's like a dark color. So that getting the warmness, the dark color feathers on the back absorb the light, providing warmth. A layer of bubbler under the thick skin. Bubbler under the thick skin provides insulation from cold. Insulation. The blizzards, when blizzards, thunder, the ice, outward behavior, but a storm with a lot of snow, storm with a lot of storm, and a strong wind. A blizzard occurs, the birds huddles together in a group of stay warm. So, my dear student, you can see the figure. Changing the coat color in the Antarctic fox, the figure 7.9, the page number 100, and next figure 7.10, penguins in the huddles, and this is the 7.8 polar bears. So with the help of figure you can see, because right now you are in ETA or many some other place, but at all in India, but the polar bear not in India. So you can see with the help of figure, and you can see with the help of your smartphone, and change the Arctic fox. Okay, so this will help you for your study. Next, migration. At that time I talked to you about the migration, and some student give me the example about the migration. That time you are in 6th standard, so many that time before I explained, I simply asked a question with my class, what the migration? Some students say go to here and there, but second time I told Siberian bird. Some student confused, but some student say, sir, some birds come from the other country in our ETA city. I showed to them. That time I think some student think that is the right way, migration. Go hither and thither, and some birds come from the other country. So directly I will say to you, Arita is a good example of, for migration, because of Patna, Pakshi Vihar, near Arita
city.
You know all well, yeah. Patna Pakshi Vihar, near ETA city, Jaleshwar,
near Bangi.
in a winter season. So many birds come from the other country for the cold plus country, Siberian birds. And I'm not saying all birds come in winter in Victoria Park, but some birds come from Victoria Park at 10 or 5 birds, but 100 and men 50, 100 and we can say many more. So all birds come in the Patna Pakshi Vihar, Jaleshwar. So the good example, any good example of the migration. So my dear student, migration, what is migration? According to your book, it at time birds, fish, insect and many other animals move in groups from one place to another at a particular time of the year, sometimes covering very large distance. This mass movement of animals in response to seasonal change is called migration. Response to seasonal change. Pass the very long distance, cover the many long distance for taking some food. This is called the migration. Animals migrate to avoid hostile climate condition. Hostile climate condition means those conditions not according to him. That's called the hostile climate condition. If that animal want the winter, but that is not winter, that animal will move. That animal want the some food for eating, but that is not food in a, that means that animal will migrate. Suppose that this is the A place and this is the B place. A bird, here is no food, here is a food item. And then birds take the food, all food item, and my food item has finished. And here are food item, that bird will fly, go to the place for eating some food item. So by this feature, the birds, animals leave the place for searching the food, for climate. Mind the good climate. So by this reason, they will change the one place to another place. Animals migrate to avoid hostile. So that time, this place will call the hostile. Not according to him. Not favorable. Means not favorable places. To take advantage of food that is available in particular season at distant place and for breeding. They come back to their homes once the condition there becomes favorable. When they come back in condition favorable, when they will come back in condition favorable. An Arctic duck often flies distance of more than 35,000 km in a winter, migrating from the Arctic to the Antarctica region and back again, clocking the longest migration of any living being. India hosts lakhs of migratory birds in winter. India hosts, Jaleshwar Patna Pakshi Vihar host of migrate birds in winter. Some of the popular destinations of sport migratory birds in India are Bharatpur, Rajasthan, Chilka Lake in Odisha, according to your book. Now Super Bird Sanctuary in the Gujarat, in the Kumarakom Bird Sanctuary in Kerala, and I will tell you Patna Pakshi Sanctuary in the Patna Pakshi Vihar, also in Eta, in UP, in India. So, Patna Pakshi is an animal example for you. Next, adaptation of animal living in tropical rainforest. Next, adaptation of animals living in tropical regions.
Rain forests.
Again, unfavorable condition. As before, this I discussed to you. Poles region. Migration, change of place. Next attraction, animal living in tropical rainforest. We have all time with the rain. Tropical rainforests are located near the equator and receive plenty of the rainfall. Plenty of rainfall. They have a hot and humid climate throughout the year. Hot and humid climate. Humid climate means a lot of vapor in the environment. The days and nights are almost equal in the length throughout the year. Tropical rainforests are found in southern, Southeast Asia, in the Southeast Asia, Central America, Central Africa, and the Western Ghats and Greater Assam region in the northwest of India. As the climate in these places is conducive to life, conducive, favorable. A large variety of plant and animals thrive in their host. With such large numbers, the competition for space is to shiver that animals have special adaptation to shiver there. Survive there. The animal have special adaptation to survive there. Competition will be definitely will create because the limited place. Gorilla, monkey, apes, jaguars, tigers, elephants, sloth, bears, lizard, snakes, many insects and large variety of birds such as toucans, parrots, owls and hornbills live in the rainforest. Generally, animals are more active during early morning, evening or night to avoid high temperature during the day. As the climate is hot and humid, animals have features for faster evaporation of water to keep their body cool. Many animals are adapted to living on the tree. Tree give them food and shelter by providing a hiding place to escape their predators. Such animals who spend majority of the parts of their lives on tree are called arboreal animals. Arboreal animals, those animals who live on the tree, who get shelter from the tree, take food from the tree, mostly they live on the tree. As we are live in our home, in our house, as animals live on the tree. The spider monkey and the gibbon are long legs and tail. These allows them to swing through the rainforest, can be unhind suspended by their tail. The food on fruits, nuts and flowers and nearly descend to the forest floor as their food is readily available on the trees. The red-eyed tree frog has sticky pads on its feet to help climb tree or climbing tree. The lion-tailed mastiff is found in the rainforest of the Western Ghats. It has a silver-white mane. It has a good climber and it is a good climber and spend a major part of its life on tree. It feeds on fruits, seeds, buds and leaves. It also catch insects from under the bark of the tree. Catch the insect. Toucan use its long large beak to reach fruit on weak branches that cannot bear the weight of any animal. The elephant is always adapted to living in rainforest. Its long sensitive trunk facilitates a good sense of smell. Trunk The trunk is a usual. The trunk is also used for picking a food and to suck a butter, which is then sprayed over its body for cooling. Suck butter, spray on our body, getting the cooling. It's a fine function of the trunk. Its large floppy ear. Its large floppy ears. Large floppy ears act like a fan. Helping the animal to cool down. So many times when the inverter not work and light is not, that time you use the fan, head fan. As same elephant always use a head fan, ear fan. Because in the forest there is no inverter and the light. By this reason, elephant use their ears as a fan and cool down. The long tusks are used for digging. Long tusks. Teeth, long tusk, digging, long tusk, okay, digging, flighting, fighting, digging, fighting, and for tearing the bark of the tree, in the bark of the tree which it eats. So it is a condition of the adaptation, how to live. Some animals are camouflaged to hide from their prey or predators. They hide from the predators. Jaguar uses its spotted coat to merge with their speck of light on the forest floor, making it difficult to be seen as it approaches its prey. So I will see you some figures. Start from this polar bears, the page number 99, and Arctic fox, page number figure 7.9, figure 7.1, penguins in the huddles. A huddle is a group of penguins. Arctic tern, Siberian birds, Arctic birds, for go to the migration to the other place. And this is a monkey, gibbon, red eye, tree frog. Tree frog live on the tree. Lion tail, macaque, toucan, 7.14 figure. This figure on the 102 chapter, 102, page 102. And jaguar figure 7.15. That is. Speckled sunlight, with the speckled sunlight colors. So this is not hard in the overall chapter. Weather climate as a degree of recording, and next part is the how to check weather stations and climate adaptation animal adaptation in the polar bears poles. And rainforest area migrations and complete. Not a hard chapter. Okay, my dear student, you have to study with carefully and a good thing. So without take any type of tension, you have to complete your this chapter without take any hesitation. Okay, my dear student. So adaptation of the animals is the good for their conditions. According to the condition, they do work. Okay, as you are in trap any winter area, that time you have to find the umbrella. If you not umbrella, then you will find the place where you can save air clock and other things, and fooding area you will find the food. So my dear student, chapter number 7 has finished, and it was easy, not hard. Okay, my dear student. So take enjoy and save from corona and other things. Okay, one thing is that you have to do your work regularly. Your PDF files which I will send you, you have to do regularly. You will not pending work. Okay, you have to not show the pending work. You have to do your work completely. Okay, bye bye.